A 31V Elante by Jayco coming in here at Haylett RV of Coldwater, Michigan. 2,930 miles with about 70, 71 hours on the generator. This was actually the very first Elante we ever sold here at Haylett RV of Coldwater, Michigan. The owners swapped up from a smaller motorhome to this one, had plans to, you know, go to here, there, everywhere, Florida, 2-3 times a year. And it just didn't work out. They just weren't using it as much as they thought. Thankfully, whenever they were not using it, it was stored indoors, so it hasn't just sat there neglected, beaten on by the sun. And with the way that the generator responded, they obviously kept this thing preventatively maintained. And I mean, it is shining, gleaming, clean inside. You are not inheriting someone else's problems. You're getting a killer deal on a late model motorhome that's had very little use.
One of the questions I always ask myself on any used RV is, does the generator work? And yeah, works well. Fired right up like a champ, no spitting and sputtering. So it looks like, you know, they preventatively maintain this. It doesn't have like a gummed up carburetor or anything. Runs nice and clean.
Got the slides closed currently for travel mode access visibility. Now what I kind of like here is how they made the kitchen countertop sort of peninsula bump outward, but they made it sort of follow the floor plan contour of the slide out. What I mean by that is the dinette sticks out farther than the sofa. So they sort of, you know, bent the countertop back that way to make this very comfortable, easy to walk through. If you have to, you know, go two people wide to get through here, you know, you might do a tiny little travel trailer two-step, but nothing major. Now, what's also neat here is it's not like a bendy bed that you'll lose access to in transit. When you're going down the road, you still have the ability to utilize, you know, bedroom, bathroom, anything you need. And the previous owners, sweethearts that they are, even left us a nice little message. You know, we hope you'll enjoy it as much as we did. Actually, I hope you enjoy it more, because that was the only problem. These folks didn't get to enjoy it as much as they wanted to. Now, the moment you hop inside, you realize this thing is spick and span. I mean, like, if I get right down here, if we look right at the floor, it is shining, it's gleaming, it's clean. I'm not proud of this fact, guys, because whenever you buy a new RV from Haylett RV, we clean it for you at no additional charge, but this is cleaner than when we let it go to our customers. This is, like, time capsule flawless kind of situation. We have a 7-foot interior ceiling clearance that gives you that extra headroom to really, you know, enjoy yourself at your destination. Obviously central air, but you may have noticed also that we have a carpetless main area here with no heat vents in the floor, so you don't have to worry about like tracking dirt, debris through it, anything like that. Entertainment setup on this one is excellent. You've got that sofa directly across from the large HD TV over here, so that's always easy viewing. And we'll come back to that in just a second, but right now I want to start up here in the front cab area. One of the benefits of a Class A versus a Class C is this. It's that your cab area becomes part of the living area. So in an almost identical floor plan, you could look at the Greyhawk 29MV that we have here. It's effectively the exact same layout. However, you don't regain the use of these spinning chairs right here. And since this is in the used market, you can get this used A for less than a new C. And you're gonna do well. So, you know, literally getting more space for less money. That's not a bad gig. Now you notice that we have the full privacy shades up front here. So when you do need to block everything out, you can. I do kind of need to pull them for camera purposes, otherwise the camera struggles. Now this was built before the very popular overhead power bunk option was added to this. Naturally, the question for those who might be curious, can it be added? And I'm going from memory here. I believe it can be, but I also know that it's not easy to do. So it's probably not something you're gonna want to get into. But hey, it's your purchase, not ours. Right-hand chair that's spun around right now, that's just kind of a real simple mechanical chair. The driver's chair is power adjustable, however. Of course, we've got, you know, the like sort of all-in-one electronic system going on right here. Your backup camera, your DVD, all that good stuff. But what I really wanted to point out here is not just like the power shades or the roller shades on the side windows, but the fact that we have a full power leveling system here, because that is something that in this class and price point, a motorhome will sometimes lack. You will see that that is not the case here. Now, as I take a step back here, give you a good look, I love the lighter fabric decor package that they have here. I'm always a fan of lighter. Lighter feels brighter to me, brighter feels bigger, and bigger feels better. That's just kind of the general mantra, I think, that follows here. Big windows for tons of light, plus those light colors open it right up. Now, both the dinette and that sofa can fold down into additional sleeping spaces. The 7-foot interior plus the slide plus the big windows give us a huge expansive feel. And what's also helping us here is that right in the main entryway, you see that we've got excellent door side visibility. Now, again, remember, I have that privacy window shade shut there for camera reasons, because a big bright window will mess with my lens. But over here, in conjunction with that, you've got excellent visibility. Also, you have a full window in the entry door. But if you look up here, you see that that does have a privacy shade. That shade can go all the way down past this window. So it's not like they forgot that fact. Another thing that they didn't forget is a ton of storage in this thing. They also made it very easy to access thanks to just smart little decisions like this, like the little side cabinet door here, so that if while you're traveling, something kind of scoots, it doesn't go to a place that you can't reach it. And you also find that there are easier reach outlets here. They were very conscious of kitchen appliances when they put this together. Sprayer kitchen faucet here, making cleanup nice and simple. Plywood box drawers, pocket screwed construction, everything, built to be able to last. This is a simple but smart quality built segment of Jayco's here. Now, all the remotes, all the manuals, all the everything that you ever wanted to know, any documentation or piece of paper that ever related to this RV, is all present and accounted for. These folks were absolutely on top of it. Now, you've got excellent prep space and serving space, but again, from the super slide here that we're looking at, you've got also excellent visibility of the entertainment center. Now, in the overhead kitchen cabinetry, right up here directly above the TV, this is where you'd find like all of your entertainment hookups. So all that stuff doesn't have to like occupy the kitchen counter. They were very intelligent in how they wired all that up here. The refrigerator, ooh, what size is this? I believe this is a 10 cubic foot fridge freezer. It's been a little while, so I had to kind of fire from memory there, with a nice pantry space beside as well. Now, moving through here, I have a bad habit of forgetting bathrooms, so I want to make a point to get in here right away. For some reason, in motorhomes, I've missed them a few times. Simple, but effective. That's the idea behind this. Nothing is over the top, flashy, fancy. It's effective. It's clean. It's cute. And it's, also not exorbitantly expensive, but it gets the job done. Now, a very space-efficient thing you see in a lot of motorhomes is the sort of walk-through split middle bathroom. But remember, again, with a 7-foot-tall ceiling, you've got tons of headroom space in here. Now, speaking of, let me just back up here and take a look at it. First, I want to zoom in on the fact in the bedroom that you do have a max air vent fan up here, so you can get some awesome airflow. And I love that big rear window, and that in conjunction with the big mirrors on that wardrobe closet make this rear room feel huge, but almost as huge as the absurd amount of storage that you have staring at us right now. So we begin with this big like double size closet, and I love that extra overhead shelf above. They didn't hang the curtain rod 7 foot high in the air. They hung it where it's easy to reach, but you still have that extra little bonus shelf above. It makes a lot of sense. Now, up here, this is where if you wanted to add a TV to the bedroom, what you'd basically do is you'd put the TV over this little opening here and maybe remove this cabinet door, because there are TV hookups up in there. But then we just have drawers galore in this thing. And these are big, they are deep, and they're so large that they're actually blocking and hiding the extra drawer space below them. Now, when they're all opened up like that with the angle that I'm standing, you couldn't really get a good sense of depth and scope and scale. So I did want to leave one of these big dresser drawers here open so you could really see what I was talking about. I close that down and you can see we've got 6 more very respectable dresser drawers in their own right going on here. And as we turn around above the bed, we have, you guessed it, more storage space. So that's what's kind of cool about this one. If you really, really want to pack heavy, or just leave the RV packed so that when you're ready to go, You can just turn the key and hit the road. This one is going to be ready, set, and able to get the job done for you.
I want to start outside by looking at the exterior storage capacity here. These are all compression latch doors, which is going to throw some people off because you're inclined to just fling them shut. And you will very often see dealers, like sometimes I'll even have a little slip of the tongue, refer to it as a slam latch door, when in reality it's a different thing. Usually you can get away with just flinging it pretty darn hard and calling it good, but what you're supposed to do is, you know, just kind of swing the door shut like normal and then press on it and you'll hear it click. Now you can see here how you have, whoop, come on camera, work with me here. You've got a pair of kind of over the hump pass-throughs. This being a gasser, it does have a drivetrain that goes down the middle, so it doesn't have like a full diesel pusher pass-through belly, but hey, something's better than nothing there. That little slide-out battery tray has room for a second battery if you are so inclined. Now there's some accessories included with this, like the brake buddy on the left here. That's an expensive piece of equipment. If you're not familiar with what that is, basically what you do is you set it effectively up on the brake pedal of the vehicle that you're towing. And when you hit the brakes on the RV, it'll hit the brakes on the vehicle so that they're working together. So one is not doing work of the other. There's also going to be some hardware associated with that, like your tow bar stuff. And you can see there's like wheel covers and whatnot in there. And then just an additional handy little open bay. Speaking of, your tow bar is going with it. They really no longer have any need for it. So they said, why not? Maybe it'll help this thing sell. So this, the equipment that goes with it, they said, let's just run all that stuff out of here. Over here is going to be our electrical hookup area. Now, what is nice is you don't have to open the door and dangle it out. There's a little feed port where you can run that through. Your sort of like sewer docking station, all that good stuff. Your water hookup type area over here. This is just, this is your actual dump station right here. And then this is the opposite side of those pass-through compartments, just to give you a reference point. Now, of course, you know, generator being present. This is a 4,000 watt because this is a 30 amp coach, so there is no need for anything larger because, you know, the RV can't use more power than that effectively. Overall, you know, the pass-through compartments are, well, the storage compartments in general on the outside of an RV, that's something that I've kind of started looking at on used motorhomes, because people who tend to keep their motorhomes in excellent shape, they will tend to keep those pass-through bays nice and tidy. But it's an out-of-sight, out-of-mind area. So if it's the RV's been owned by a non-attentive owner, then it is an area where you can kind of eyeball some neglect if it were present. And I don't see an ounce of that there. Now, once again, outside here, this was stored indoors when not in use. So it has not been, you know, brutalized by harsh, you know, sun, snow, anything like that. Actually, I don't know if this thing's ever seen a snowflake. I think that was the point. And if they were up here during that season, they were off the road. So it's not like it's been salted and corroded to death. I want to draw your attention to that monstrous windshield. You notice how you cannot see side beams as we're standing in front of it, the little corner posts. That's because this has and especially when this came out, and it's still true today, the largest in class front windshield, you know, at this like budget segment. It's 120 inches from corner to corner. It is huge. It's this big one-piece monstrosity, actually imported from Italy. It's the same windshield used in Integra Coach diesel pushers, a Jayco subsidiary. You've also got, in similar logic, a one-piece nose cap here, so there's no seams where water can kind of try to sneak in, around, or through. And hey, just for fun, you got those little lower accent lights down there, but I bet Johnny Law's gonna frown on you using those in transit. Slide awnings here, protecting her for the long haul, reducing overall care and maintenance required. Also, in hot climates, kind of providing a little bit of organic shade to the top of the slide out to help manage heat inside the RV. Always a lovely thing. Now your side mirrors there, they are several things. They are, you know, power, they are heated, they have integrated side view cameras. So as soon as you kick on your turn signal, matching, you know, camera will also kick on. So you can see who's in that turn lane before you go crushing a Yugo. I also want to point out here a just gorgeous high gloss skin. And again, no fade, no weathering of decals or anything like that. Everything here is good looking, as are the tires. I don't see anything scary on these beautiful Goodyear radials. 19 and a half inch tires, by the way. Now, as we back up here, let's see, what do we want to talk about back here? How about holding tank heaters? How about that?
This has 12-volt heaters, which allow you to be, functional in motion. Then there's little things like a third brake light, just little safety items like that that Jayco puts in here. So we talked about the towing bar, but this does have a 5,000-pound towing capacity, which should be enough to have like a small dolly, small vehicle, mid-sized vehicle, or whatever, if it's flat towable. And if it is flat towable, hey, congratulations, you already got most of the hardware that hooks up to it. We have a outside entertainment center right here that is right next to our awning, but what's cool is this provides separate interior and exterior entertainment options. But before we get too far along, I want to make quick note of the roof as well. Like a big diesel pusher, this has a one-piece fiberglass roof membrane. So once again, reducing overall care and maintenance required to keep this thing in good working order. That's a fantastic feature. Now, over here is that little entertainment center, and this is behind all those ridiculously sized dresser drawers. That's what's crazy, is you have all that storage and still have room for outdoor fun stuff. So you have separate, TV, speakers, stereo system, extra plugs out here. This is a perfect little spot to keep your phone charging up when you're outside the RV, by the way. Now, our power awning here, smooth like butter. I was happy with that. Now, you notice that you don't see an LED light strip at the base there. What they often do on motorhomes is they will put the lighting in the awning tube so that you can kind of control the direction of it. Also, when the lights are in the tube, they're not pointing at the neighbor's campsite, because this person camping in this Freedom Express or this Cougar or whatever over here, they don't want your lights in their face. And actually, exterior lighting at night is the number one complaint, filed at campgrounds, with, loud noises being number two. So, I think we have pretty much nailed it, ladies and gentlemen. Now, whether you need, hitching pieces, parts, you have a trade, you need financing, we do it all at Haylett RV, so you can just go camping and have a good time. So take care, stay safe, have fun, and happy camping, everyone. Have a great day.